classes and objects. So there is much of a theory you need to like read if you were to start by your own. Okay, so the way I'm going to teach is we are going to go through many of the examples, many examples, and we are going to focus on class and its objects. First of all, we need to know what is an object-oriented program. So in Python, when we use class, we have subparts of class like objects, which we create. And these objects are dummy for use in programming, which compares or corresponds to some real life objects. Yeah, so I will start. Okay. Yeah, you can pretty much read what is OOPS. So the OOPS concept is around creating objects and using it. First of all, it is a method of structuring a program by bundling related properties and behaviors into individual objects. Okay, so it is relatable to functions, but there are some distinctions. Okay, it is objects what we create here. In functions, we have other things like variables, etc. Also, this also takes arguments, but it has multi-level properties. It has inheritance, etc. We can create class, we can create subclass, etc. I would like to be on class objects. Now defining the class. Okay, so class name. Okay, so while creating the function, okay, while creating the function, just a second. While creating the function, we used to use def, right? But instead of that, here in class, we will use class, okay? And we will use class name. Now, we don't need to use the round brackets because the arguments, etc., whatever we are going to give, okay, would be created as separate objects, okay, inside the class. So let me give some example. So the primary class, most primary or primitive class, which I can give is this one. I have created a class, say my class. Okay. And this is just a comment. Okay. And this is how you can comment it. It is very useful in class because class is not as simple as a function. Okay. So we need to specify what we are doing. So if someone else is coding on your code, or if someone wants to read your code, it would be best if you would write this quotes. Okay, this is not important, of course, but there must be some important things you would like to mention. So in this class, I can define a variable. So I have defined a variable that is I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, to access this I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, see, I have ran it already. So first of all, I'll read. So now I will run this. I will restart the kernel. The reset is not working. Okay. I've restarted the kernel. Now, yes, I is nothing. It is not defined. Now, this is my class, right? I have defined a variable, say I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Focus on this only for now. Now, what I'll do is now I will check. Yeah, it is not sequential. I can just run it in upper block also. So still I is not defined. So I am not able to access the value of I, which is defined in my class using the statement class. Okay. So this is the thing. This is the keyword to start taking the class. Okay. So Python understands when we have used this class, the name, the colon, etc., as we used to do in function using def. Now, this is one similarity what we observed, because when we have a function, say f, okay, we have a function, and what do? We say r is equal to 1. Okay, let us take something else, j is equal to 1. Now, what would be the answer? So there is nothing to print here, first of all. It is just a function with the none value, okay, like always. But now, if I want to find what is j, so it is not defined. So this is a similarity of class and function. Okay, now if I want to access okay, just a second. I'm just doing control Z here as this is not modified yet. The cell is there. Okay, so you can use that. Now, if I want to use F in somehow so that I can access the value of J inside it, do you recall anything which I explained in the last session? Or any, everything which we have done in the function till now? Are you sure that we can access J is equal to 1 from that? Yes or no, you can write in the chat. Okay. So if I want to do something, okay, I can't, because this function has a very simple, okay, instead class has a complex description. As I said, function has a round bracket to take its methods, okay, and function can be multi-method, okay. For example, previously if you wanted to define a function, say you define a function, aapko ek function mila, it is piecewise, for x is equal to 1 it is something and it is something for else. So we use if and else, right? So that is also one thing which we can do, okay. Due to time constraints, I have not done that all part, okay. Now in class, if I want to access this I, so if I want to access this I, so what I'll do, I'll go for my class, okay, dot I. So what do we get? We get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is, or this cannot be done in function. Okay. So this cannot be done in functions. We can't access each and everything, okay, from that function. But yes, in class, we define everything to be like a map, and we know how to access it using methods, using the objects, using the functions. And function is like a subpart of class. We can introduce this as a subpart. Now, you can see that this function is introduced as a subpart, like the class contains the function. It is not like we can't nest, it is called nesting. It is not that we can't nest a function into a function. We can do that too, okay? But the way of accessing it is not the same, okay? When we try to do this, for example, this, define k here, okay? And we say return 1, and we also execute it. Say we execute it. Yeah, this is all meaningless, but I'm just trying to show what it does. What do we get? We get f of this is 1. So it works, right? It works nicely. But how can we call k alone? For example, this f, okay, if I were to have something else in return. Okay, for example, if I have, say, two functions, say k and this is k1, okay, and now I have to return here Still, I need to mention here K1, so that I can get both the things. But what if you want to access only one? Yeah, it is obvious that you can do this thing, right? If I have just mentioned this indices one, that is the first one, or you can do zero. But what is the problem here? If I remove this indice, it already calculates 1, 2. So it is little painful that we want one, or we want either one or either two, but we want to get either one, but we have to call both of them, and then we would decide that which one we want. Also, there is no identity here. Like while defining the function, it is at zeroth position. It is at first index. So I can call it using this. But that is not good, right? Because maybe we have something else in mind. Maybe we can't keep it as a single list or a tuple what we get here. Okay. So for that, the introduction of objects and class was done. Okay. So if I want to access this function, like apart from handling I, we don't need to call I, right? For that, we just need to call f. So myclass.f, it doesn't work here for now. I will tell you why. Okay, but just to see that it is okay to say that I have called f the function, it won't work like this. I will tell you why. So at least we got f, right? This is the location. Okay, first of all, it is giving me that what is it. It is showing me how to use it. I'll tell you now. This function, we can't access it because we haven't created the instance of the class. We haven't created the instance of the class. So this class, my class, we are not going to write my class every time. We can just say that my class is something else. Okay. Like a variable, we don't write n. For example, in the last session, we used n, right? N is equal to 5, say. And we wanted to use it throughout the iteration. Do we have to type in 5 every time? No, right? Because we took n is equal to 5. It is a similar case where we don't need to write my class again and again, which also enables us to use the call function defined exactly. So let us say I define m is equal to my class. Okay, m is equal to my class, and now I use m.f. Okay, I can use m.i also. Let us see what that gets, where that gets us to m.i. So now m is not defined, just a second. I haven't run it. So m.i, it works fine. What about m.f? Yeah, now it works fine. So if there is some confusion, I will repeat again that my class is nothing but a shell. As I said previously, we have defined all the things, but there are certain rules because of the other advantages what we get. We need to create an instance. Okay, instance, that is M. So M is an instance of the class my class. I will be doing anything with this M. Okay, but this properties would be there with my class. But if I do any changes with them, which we will see in the coming examples, it won't be changing my class. It would be the change in the instance of M. Okay. So if I create something, say N. Okay. And this is also my class. Now, what is M.I here? Okay. And what is N.I? Please pay attention carefully. Now, what I'm going to do is command mode B. Okay. What I'm going to do is m.i, I'm going to say it is 1, 2, 3. What I did, m.i is equal to 1, 2, 3. Now, let us see what is m.i now. Can you see what is it? It is 1, 2, 3. But if I want to see my class dot I, it is still 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Have I made the point that what is an instant? And yeah, I won't go with the definition, like you can Google it, what is an instant in the class and how to do what to do step wise. But the thing is, while working with these examples, we can see that what are the obstacles we need to face. For example, for the function, we had to face this obstacle that without instance, we can't access that function. Are you getting me? Okay. Now, if I want to change the function also, okay, there are some other methods which we can do. But for now, I'll stick to this I. I have changed the I in the instant M. But in N, there is no change. For example, if I say N dot I, still there is no change because N is another instant. Okay, it is accounting for another space. Okay, it is like we have a multiverse of my class. Okay, and we want to change in one, and we want to keep the copy as the same so that we can multiply it again and again afterwards for our other use. Okay, now there is another example which I have taken from the documentation of classes. So this is the creation of class dog. And what is its kind? It is canine. Now, why I have chosen this, that we can enter the new records in this class. Okay, by records, I mean new variables. Okay, for example, here it is kind, right? So I have just ran it. Now the class dog will always have this kind and this init function. Okay, the init function is the function which gives out let me tell you, if there was a if you see this function, right, we are returning k and k1, but in classes this function itself, if we want to have a return for this function f, we try to use the init function. Ke kabhi bhi main ye class ko direct bulaunga na, whenever I chose this class, okay, this function f, मुझे आंसर उसका मिले. ओके, एंड बाकी सारी चीजों को एक्सेस करने के लिए मुझे के और के वन मेंशन करना पड़े, राइट? बिकॉज ऑफ कोर्स इफ आई वांट टू डू दिस एफ ऑफ ब्रैकेट विद द क्लास, तभी मुझे कुछ भी आंसर नहीं मिलेगा बिकॉज आई हैवंट मेंशन एनीथिंग इन रिटर्न, राइट? सो इट इज एम्प्टी व्हेन यू आर नॉट मेंशनिंग इनिट. अगर मैं इनिट मेंशन नहीं करता हूँ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैंने पहले इनिट मेंशन नहीं किया था, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट रीजन मेरा माई क्लास का जो फंक्शन था, इट गेव मी नथिंग. ठीक है, बट अगर इनिट है, देन इट विल गिव मी समथिंग. ओके, एंड इनिट अभी हम लोग ने इनिट जो पढ़ा है उसके अंदर हम लोग ने नेम मेंशन किया, वी हैव मेंशनड दिस नेम हियर. सो व्हाट आर वी गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू राइट द नेम ऑफ द डॉग्स, ओके, इंडिविजुअली, एंड इट वुड बी रिकॉर्डेड इन द क्लास डॉग. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, this is d is equal to dog feed. Now before this there was empty argument, right, when we were creating. So I am creating this instant m with my class empty. Now here I am creating it for d. So already the class has some information, that information is canine. So I have two dogs, say Fido and Buddy. Okay, they both belongs to kind of canine. So what I'll do, I'll create, if something is common, like kind is common, four legs is common, one tail is common, etc. This all information which is common, I can mention in the class dog. It is very primitive to understand. And then I will create the instances like d is equal to this, e is equal to this, and I can access what is its kind. Okay, so this is a very small picture. Okay, so d dot kind, e dot kind, both will be the same. That is canine. What is the e dot name? What is the name of this d? So we have mentioned it. Okay, I have not ran it yet. Now it would be there. So when we have the name, so this dog d, the instant d, has the name Fido, and the e name, this dog's name is Buddy. Okay, moving on to now the higher level things. If someone has a doubt, they can write it, what is an instant and etc. in the chat box. Chat box is open. I can read it. I will take a few seconds pause and I'll move on to the other class.
Sir, is D and E part of class now?
Yes, because we have mentioned in it now. Okay, but it is unique to D and unique to E. The names what we enter using the class dog, it is just adding the information kind and creating an instant D or E. If it is not understood, you can hit me with the specific or particular question, whichever you like. You can take your the example of yours. You can ask the way out. Okay. I think someone who asked me just now, she got her doubts clear. So I'll move on. Now, class India. Of course, we will start with, say, class India. So I'm creating class India. So what information we would like to give to the class India? Okay. We would like to give some information. I'm just creating the class. I will give two methods. This is the first method. So first of all, this thing can be empty, which we already saw, correct? This can be empty. Now what I'll say, I'll just give two things, like two variables, that is number of states. So I'm writing n states. So what are the number of states? Say I'm writing 28 and number of union territories, 9. Okay, geography class. Okay, so I'll run this. What do I get? Can I access them? It is very easy. Say India. We all know that this would give us the answer. There are no functions that would give me some error. India. Dot tab, we have this thing. So what do we get? 28 and 9. Now I am just taking more and more examples so that you are through with this. Now what I'll do is I'll take an instant, say A, India. Okay, so this is the first method. This is method one, which I am dealing with right now. A is equal to India. I have created India, right? Now I want to print, which I have already done. A dot, first of all, I need to run this so that I can use the tab. Now I can use the tab. I can use print. If I don't use print, then also it is okay. Okay, I'm getting this. This is 28 and 9. Yeah, of course, there is no comma in between. Can you observe something different? If I were doing this and this, just for observing that this A instant, what we created, the output, what we get here, 28 and 9, they are separated by a space. Okay, just something different what we observe in classes. Okay, now we'll create some spaces more. Now, what do we need to do next is we will name, okay, we will name them. Okay, now what I want to do is I am going to create something bigger, method two. Actually, I have noted down some things in my notes. I'll write it down so we won't waste the time. We will take method two as the same thing. Okay, now the information which I'm going to do, which I'm going to use right now, is the same. In addition to that, okay, what I'll do is I can see that print mein mujhe type karna padta hai, A is equal to India likh ke. Like previously I didn't answer it ke hum log kaise directly function le sakte hain, etc. So for that also we have a we have some object which we can create ke directly hum log us cheez ko print kar sake. So what I will do is we will create a function, say display, okay, and sell. whenever I write self, that means it is just India. Okay. And okay, so what I'll print here is jabhi bhi main is class ko use karu, sorry. So jabhi main ye class ko use karu, what I'll get is number of states in India. That would be in states. Is it the correct way? It is not. It is going to work. Just a second. The reason I'm doing this is a very simple, but the reason I'm doing this is because you should know what are the differences in function, and when we define a function inside the class, there are some things we need to take care of while printing also. Okay, so now first of all, I am just defining this thing, and this would be India. Okay, India, I am not going to use about things. I have done this thing, and now I'll use this display function. Please mute. If you are going to ask something, please write it in the chat box. So display, I am going to display India. Use the this, and yeah. And when I create this, first of all, there is an error. I need to tell you right now that what is the error here. Note, while using any inbuilt variable in class, say where we need to write it as self dot variable, self dot variable, self dot function, etc., whatever. So variable, or say any object what we create. So we will write object here. So here the change which I would like to make is self here dot. See, it changed the color because it recognizes that we have mentioned this already. Okay, if it was not, then it won't change the color. Yeah, there are a few more things I would like to add. So I am also defining.
Sir, first of all, this self can be named anything, right? It's just a very any name. A, B, C. We can name anything.
Yeah, actually we can just change this thing. Are you seeing this?
Yes,
the inside display, whatever we mentioned now, you can just mention S also, but to remember it, it is easy to write self, right?
Okay.
Because being in my learning days, I made many mistakes while writing, because I used to take S, just S, and there was some iterations I was working. Like if I were to use Heron's formula, etc., and I'm creating a class, say triangle, and I'm doing everything with it. Try to get it is scalene or not, it is right angle or not, okay, and its area. So there were some things which coincides, and self doesn't coincide. Okay, so you just use a keyword which is very unique, and you are not going to use it throughout the class. Okay, then it would be okay. Fine.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so this is the first method. Now, I have already missed something because I wanted to introduce the init method. That is double underscore init double underscore. You know why do we use it, right? I already told. Okay, we have used it above. So this is what this is. This is the constructor. Okay, I have not mentioned this before, I guess, because when we created this name of the dolls, it behaved like we are constructing something, right? So it is a constructor. Here it takes only one thing, that is the name of the doll. Here we will construct something else. So I can use another method. Okay, so kindly wait. This is say method 3. Yes, we will see what is the difference. Method 3. And here, instead of display, I will use init. Now this doesn't work right now. We need to take this double underscore. Okay. Forward and backward. Now I need to insert something in India. So what do we have? Another information. Say area of our country and the population. It is case sensitive. Python is case sensitive. So now what I'm going to change. Here we will say self.area, okay, is equal to area. Now have we wrote area? No, we have to construct it. Like we can give it as the name of the dog where we mentioned the name. So population, okay, it is population very long, okay. Population, okay, so what I have done here, this is an object variable. You should have the habit of doing such things. Okay. And it's okay. Now I will try to print it. So init does the work of printing it as before. Before it was printing only the name of the dog. Now we have to print both of the things. I hope you are following whatever I'm saying. If not, please ask me. Okay. And here we can use anything. Say we use F only. But F gives us a quote, right? So I will avoid that quote and I will use format. So dot format. And what do we have? We have area, comma, population. Okay. Now, can anyone in method 3, can anyone tell me what is the error? This I'll remove. Something which I have already discussed in the last example. Anything you would like to add up? Any correction? I may be wrong. I'm just a human. See before the definition of density and try to point out some problem and write it in the chat box. I just gave a hint also. Of course, whatever I'm writing is logical. That is population divided by the area. That would be the density. We are talking about the human mass here. Okay. Now this is, there is another hint. Anyone? Okay, let's run it. I'm just putting it down. Okay. Method 3. Display India. Okay, India. Now let us create something. So we have India. We have some population. We have some area. Something. And whatever. Okay, I'm creating this. tell me why I have taken these two things, why not any one, or can I add something more? Okay. Okay. So Rohini Shinde has pointed out correctly that here it should be self dot area, and here it should be self dot population. Thank you for being active. Please actively participate. Okay. And one more thing, just a second. If someone likes to do this, just a second. You can see my screen, right, everyone? Okay. So when you see this, I am sharing this link, okay, to everyone. If someone wants to code with me, they can code it here, given that they have not installed anything. So you just need to go in file and new notebook. File and new notebook. When you do that, there is another tab, okay, and you don't need to install anything, okay. You can just type your code, which I am typing, so that you can. I should have given this to you previously only, but okay. 1+2. Yeah, it uses internet. Okay, so you can do this also. Yeah, coming back to our stuff again. I have created this D. So what did I get? See, area is equal to this and population is equal to this. If I were to make a mistake here, see, self dot area maine nahi likha. I am running this. Okay, I have just written area by mistake, and no, it should not do like this. Okay, so. For now, I have taken self dot area is equal to area and self dot population is equal to population. That's why it's giving such thing. But if I just hash this out and run again, okay. So the problem is that we haven't mentioned this thing, that self dot area is equal to area, and we don't usually mention this both the things. एक बार हम लोग ने बोल दिया एरिया और पॉपुलेशन चाहिए, इट इज ओके, सेल्फ से डायरेक्ट हम लोग उसको ले सकते हैं, बट इफ यू हैव मेंशन दिस, आप सेल्फ नहीं डालोगे तो चलेगा. ओके, दिस एंड अबव एनेबल्स अस टू यूज एरिया इंस्टेड ऑफ सेल्फ डॉट एरिया वुड. Right, and now we will try to see what is the density. So let us see what is the density, d dot density or just density. Okay, so we got the density. If we were to give names also, name, area and population, so we can create each state's name of each state with the area and the population. We just need to change here that after self we give here state name. Okay. Now we will go to a higher level problem, that is class students. 37. Okay, I'll move a little faster. Now consider that we are creating a student class with the inputs like name. As I'm writing this, some people who are more energetic, they can use the collab link which I have done, and they can start themselves also, no problem, because you will be provided with the recording. So creating a class with inputs like a name, then the subjects Okay, 3 I'm choosing because it is okay when we use sum. It becomes a little harder. 3 subjects with same marks so that we can calculate the average. And for that, we will use the method to calculate. Okay, this sounds promising. We can also record the say, count. Let us see if we can add this. As per the time, it would be overfitting. Students. See, whatever you write the name, it would be, by now you all know that it is the capitals and smalls matter. Okay. Now I'm doing it. This is the third time I'm doing it. So you must be knowing that as per the above question, what we should mention here. So self ke saath mein kya likhu aur? Maybe the name of the student first. Now 3 subjects, so we can't write 3 subjects. We need to name them. Something. You can name subject 1, subject 2. But I'll name this, the subjects in a bachelor's. Okay. And now we don't need to add something else. Other things are the methods. What we need to mention is self.name is equal to name. Okay, this is all optional. Okay, self.name, self.saymath, self.phy, that is physics, then self.chemchem, and I'm using shortcuts. Okay, this is the init. Now student count we were going to keep, right? So student, I have mentioned capital S, right? Student dot say n. So what we have taken n for, n is the count, right? So whenever the init function is used, what we will do after each successful use of the init function, we will increase this. Does anyone know what this will do? Plus is equal to?
N into n, n is equal to n plus n.
Okay, so this is the shortcut method where we can use this for increment by 1. We can also increment it by 2, 3, etc. Okay, so this is a good way. Now, the last thing we need to print is student dot say n. Okay, that is count. Okay, now let me define something else. So maine count to define kar diya, maine mention nahi kiya phir bhi. I didn't mention the count is default in init. You can mention a function define count karke. Okay, that also you can do, but I have mentioned it in init. So whenever we try to use it again and again, we can keep the track of the count, how many students are there. Now we are defining the function average. Okay, so here it is self, and now we have self dot average tab. It's very handy. Ab kaise, how we will do it? So we need to just take math plus phy. I'm not going to write this because some of you won't use this. So I'm doing a difficult job. I'm going to name it self dot name. Okay, sorry, self dot math. I just recall that we are not going to use NumPy. Otherwise, we can use directly in this commas and we can take the sum of it. But okay, and we need to divide this by the number of subjects. And for now, we know that it is 3, so it is okay. And then we need to print it. So print self dot average. Now, being creative, average of the subjects. Is this not creative, informative? This I have done. Now let us create some students. So stu1, so the class name is student, right? So let us take some student's name. So student, first one is, to make it easier for me, I'll just take student one, copy. Then what is the marks? So first one was the name, then marks. So out of 50, I would like to fill, say 49, 25, 35, right? And what is this? I can create more students like this, but first of all, we will check if it is correct. Okay, student is not defined. Okay, sorry, I have taken students here.
Right?
So class student. Yeah. Thank you. So keyword was wrong. Now here also there is some problem. Yeah, again, capital S. Okay. Actually, the mistakes were good because you were able to learn, right? See, first time I run it, I get 1. Second time I run it, it is giving me 2. Now, what is this number? Can anyone guess? See, again, I'm running it. There's 3. Anyone? Isn't it the count? Like how many times we have run this? And it is increasing. Okay. How many times I have run this init function? Okay. So I'm just using this name, math, physics, chem. And due to that, it is getting increasing. It is not, we can just code for being it being unique, but for now I'll leave that part. Okay, so what is the next thing we need to see? That what is the average? So stu1 tab. So stu1 has this many things to give out. So if it is n, so it is 3. Okay, if it is something, you will say average function. And it is this thing. Intending to use this thing. See, when I redefined the function, it started again from 1. Okay. You can also mention some other students. Okay, average of the subject is this. Okay, we can also mention here that average of the subjects of self dot name. Okay, so now again, so student one. So if I were to average of stu1 dot average is now changed. Okay, if I take is as student 2, okay, student 1, so if you were to get a job in bank, okay, and you wanted to use class, can you use it for account creation? As it is pretty obvious because the next example is for accounts only, and it is a very nice, you can use it for a daily budget, for example, whatever like you are, if you are earning or if you are having the pocket money and you are calculating your expenditure per month. Yeah, some people like to do that. So you can use Python for that. So I'll just create, I'll just read out what I'm going to do. So we can create a account class, input name, okay, and the initial deposit in that account, okay, that is upon the creation only, okay, and then we'll create two methods, deposition and withdrawal. So this initial amount, whenever we try to add some money in your account, it will be increasing that amount and decreasing when we debit it, okay, and it would print what is your current balance, etc. things, okay. So okay, so count is equal to 0 here. I am defining init first. In init, what things we are going to take? Okay, someone asked that we can use something else. I am using s right now because I need to write it fast. AC number, name, DL means balance. Okay, then s dot AC underscore number, comma, s dot name, comma, s dot balance, and okay, that's it, is equal to account number, name, balance. Now we need to see how many accounts are there. So again, we can just use this count. Okay, now count, I have already mentioned above, it is not a function or something. Okay, count is equal to 0, I have initiated and I am incrementing it, the number of times the account is used or accessed in init to create the number of accounts. S dot count is perfect, yes. After that, we will have something like display. Ek bar display use kiya hai hum log ne. So display s will print me all the things, all the details like a account number. So mera account number kya hai, that would be given by s dot ac. I'm just doing this for you, you can use any of the option. Then balance, what is the balance? So this would be the current balance, s dot bal, but whenever you enter it, it is the initial balance, okay, like when you create the instant. Then what is the name? So the name s dot name, you can observe that I have used s in place of self. Now what I promised to include, the methods are withdrawal. So I'll use withdraw s withdraw is self dot self comma balance remaining, okay, I'll start. And this would be decreasing, right? Withdrawal. It is very easy to. So whatever the reduction is to be done, okay, like reduce the reduction to be done. So it would be decreased by the reduction, whatever withdraw we mentioned. It is very easy to understand. Then defining the deposit, you can also use the terms debit and credit if you want. Comma, balance added. S dot balance. The last thing we would like to do would be defining. I will tell you what I am doing this. If you don't have, like, if you have in it for some purpose, you need to add something else. So I will be using this string. Okay. So whenever I use, okay, I'll explain it when I do it. So I'm creating this string. It would give me an output as a string. Okay. So this, okay, so the name of the person with account number, say this has balance, okay, this, and what we'll do, we'll use dot format for this, and like always I'm going to use s. Okay, done. So now I will just create, say, A1. Okay, so we have this account, small only. Yes, small only. So account, and what are we going to write it down? So initial deposit, say 10,000. Okay, and for now it's my name. Okay, and then sorry, initial deposit, I am going to take something, say 12,000, and the first thing which I mentioned this, okay, let it be anything so that you can say that it is a account number. Okay, we don't need to mention what type of data it is. That is a okay, there is some error here. So one time I have one account, okay, I can create another. Like this, one and two. Now what I need to do, I need to print. Now I can use print. Previously I was not able to use it. When I print this str, okay, whatever we write it in str, it helps to print it. So we can use print to the instance of the class created and get this. What is this? As the return. Okay, I hope this is clear. Then what else we are going to do? You know that this is Govind. Okay, now this is Govind, and I will try to withdraw some money. So even though withdraw, how much he has? 1,20,560. I'll withdraw, say 560. Okay, now I'll check print a1. See, and if I want to say deposit, sorry, so even dot deposit, I will deposit some, say 1000 rupees. And again, I will print it here. Okay, so I have to forward this file, so I'll write it again here. Okay, so this is good. This is good. Now, what is the time? Okay, we have a little less time, and I would like to cover something mathematical. So yeah, we can use it for mathematics, the above things, and whatever functions we created, we can include it in the class. Okay. Now I'll try to give the example. This class of vectors, derivative, we'll see if we will do. It is the small thing. Okay. I'll start with the vectors. So from math. We will import some things. Okay, for now let it be. Okay, this is markdown. See, this is markdown. I am converting into code. Okay, so first of all, let us create the class, say vector. Okay, now let us name it as vec3d. Now we are going to create an object. So in real life also, like, we have some vectors, right? Okay, or in our book we study vectors. So being in that, we are creating an object named vector3, right? So I'm going to define, first of all, init. Any guesses what we will write in init? For the vectors, can anyone type? Length. Okay, it would be more of a like vector. Okay, magnitude, you mean. So it would be like a method for length when we have two vectors, right? So for now, we will have something which is more fundamental. When we define a vector, you have ever defined a vector? Like, not in computers, we just write it down. So what does a vector look like? Anyone?
Size it.
What? Can you type it? Or just repeat it clearly? Yeah, coordinates. Thanks. Thank you so much. Okay, so I'm just taking x, y, z. We could also take something, say, just v. And while inputting, we can use it as a tuple, right? And we can use of the indexes 0, 1, 2. Like, you have already known that the indexing in Python starts at 0, right? But it would be too much, right, to write using brackets, using shift, etc. So I'm just taking x, y, z differently. Okay, now what we'll do, this is the init. Okay, so we know that what we are going to do, s dot x, s dot y, s dot, okay, comma, s dot z. What are these? These are just x, y, and z. And now we will try to create some things, like, say, for examples, for starting, I am using this add. I'll ask a question from your side only. Why have you used double underscore? I'll answer it. Because add is taken, okay, this underscore is taken to be like, we can use plus sign, okay, as an operator, and it is well understood by the class. Okay, some things which are very very fundamental are already understood by the classes in Python. So when we take double underscore add double underscore, it would in writing, okay, whenever we create two vectors, we would just use plus. Okay, so when we have some two vectors, say v1 and v2, we will be defining, okay, and we will be giving x, y, and z, distinct x, y, and z. After that, we would like to add it. So what would we like to do? First of all, first vector would be say s, okay, and o would be something. S is the cell and o is the other, okay, o means other. O means other. So one is the self, okay, the self vector, and O is the other. If you want to add those two vectors, how would we return it? Okay, first of all, we need to use this vec3d, okay, otherwise it won't work. So vec3d s dot x plus O dot x. We all know that it is a coordinate wise addition, right? S dot y plus O dot y, comma s plus O dot z. So why you have used vec3d? Because it is a vector which we want in output, right? And it has three things. Okay. Instead of O, I have written 0. So you can just run it and see what it gives. Okay, import. I will use square root in future stuff. So vector, so v1 is equal to say vec3d. Okay. And we will mention x, y, z, say 1, 2, 3. Oops, it is marked down again. Code. V1 ho gaya. Say we have something else also. Second vector. 3, 2, -1. Why not take a negative? V2 shapes. Okay. This is again marked. So if you want to do V1 plus V2, will it give some answer? No. Why? And what should we do to get an answer? Can anyone say? Anyone? I've already done it in last thing. That it is not working. Let us say we use print. Is not working normally. Oh, still not working. What should we do to make print work? I'm sorry, I need answer to move forward. Anyone? I'm not getting the required answer. What should be the answer? It should be 1 plus 3, 4, 2. I'm not getting it. What should I do?
Maybe add v1, v2.
Add v1, v2.
Sir.
Okay. Yes. Yes.
So what about o dot x means o dot y? We haven't defined it.
No. O means something else. Other. Hash O means other. Are you getting it?
It's not that.
Till now. Yeah. Till now we have for addition, we need two instances, right? Addition is the method in class. We need minimum two instances if you want to add.
Vec3d dot add v1, v2.
Okay, vec3d dot dot. No, there is no add. if there is this MRO, let us see V1 plus V2 works. No, right? Actually, I have made it clear that there is something wrong. So how can we make the print work? VAC3D ke andar entering only one thing is not good enough. Y and Z also we need to enter. Anyone? Not good. I'll give a hint. I will repeat it. I want this print to work. What should I do? What is missing in the class Vector3D? I have narrowed it down. Okay, let me go forward. We have to use str to print it because the Vector3D class doesn't know how to give the answer. For example, if I say someone to bring something, and now this is computer. So I will ask logical way, get me some water. So there are many ways, right? Someone, if there is a kid, it can bring it, he can bring in his hands in a glass. We need to specify something because this vector is what we are creating. It is not from scratch. Okay. We have not defined everything. So print is unknown for it. So for that, we need to say that how it needs to give us the answer when we say print. So that's why we use str. I am repeating this thing. Last time also I said, so let me say that we will use this, comma, this. F, of course, brackets, it would be a tuple, right? What should be inside? So whatever we print, let us see if it works. Are you getting it? STR enables the print to work. What else we can add? We can add subtraction. Okay. Please, if someone is not able to understand something, please ask. Okay. Please ask. I have been informed this is the first time for you being introduced with programming language. So please ask. I'm just converting this as minus.
Okay. So what is yes. The use of this add and sub then? Where are these used? You have used V1 plus V2.
Yes. Then... So if add and subtract were not defined, we can't add this both vectors. Right? In future, you will learn that in the packages, you use matrices. We know, right? Matrices, vectors. Okay, two-dimensional vectors are matrices, etc. Okay. So, in that, already the class of vectors, etc. is added. It is like ready to use in Python, but we should know that how to create it, right? So that's why I've taken this example that how we can use it. Okay.
So this add is inbuilt function already.
Not inbuilt. If you want, you can just write add, and you can use add in the bracket v1 comma v2, right? That also you can do. But why I am choosing this thing? Because it is not inbuilt. If it was inbuilt, there is a like lack of wording, okay, those are not the best words. If it was inbuilt, then we would get the answer without defining it. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so it is not inbuilt, but it understands then when we are writing double underscore that some keywords are privileged to some operators. So add is for the plus operator, okay, the plus sign. Sub sub is for minus sign. Now if you write sub ke jagah pe subtract, then also it would work, but you will like write subtracted, it won't work. Why? Because it is not being defined. For multiplication we use mul mul, okay, and we have this again so, okay. Now in return for multiplication, how do we multiply? Anyone? We multiply to vectors. So this is mul, and here I am mentioning that this is a say dot product. Okay, so kaise karenge? See
here, using
what
s dot x into star. She's saying using star.
Oh, star using.
Yes, yes. So what we the multiply them, so plus b multiplication, right? And this commas will be plus. Is it correct? And now if I use star here, oh no, yeah, I have not mentioned it again, right? V1 and V2. Now, okay. Print V1 and V2. Something is missing. Just a second.
So return value is single.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Return value is single. So I need to do something about it. Very good. So I don't need to use VAC3D, na? VAC3D, why I was using? So that I can get 3. So I'm not using VAC3D. Okay. Nice. If I want to take something like for vector, we can calculate magnitude also, right? For which I have something about. So say ABS, absolute. Okay. So this is S comma 0. Okay, and we return, what do we return? Whatever we have done above is the same. We just need to take the square root of it. Yeah, that's correct. Copy. So math, okay, I have already imported square root. So this should do the trick. So what can I write for absolute? V1 comma ABS. Not ABS. Square root, what should I write? Just a second.
So it's product with itself and then square root, no? You are going for absolute value, then what is the requirement for the vector?
What? Can you repeat?
I'm saying that absolute value, are taking that under root of
a square. Okay, okay. Value. Sorry. I made a mistake. I took S and O both, right? That you are telling me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Sorry. So this is an example that copy paste doesn't work nicely. Now, ABS directly should work. Good. Now it works. Okay. So there are other things you can mention. I'm just leaving it to you. Okay. So we can have I have just used a double underscore, right? I will use something else. Say you need to take the cross product, Okay, so cross product, how will you take it? See if I am correct. So what will we return? We will return vec3d s dot y into s dot y into yz minus zy. Okay, so s dot y into y dot z minus s dot z into dot y. These things I'm copying out. Cross product, we get a vector again. Now first I'll change y to say x here. I'm not doing this like anything. For the first one, we need to get rid of x here. Okay, it is like we have a matrix. Okay, first is x, y, z, and then we have first is I, j, k, and then we have these two vectors. Okay, so visualize that in your mind and then do it. Okay, so does this cross work? Cross of v1 and v2. First, we need to take v1 and v2. Cross is not defined. Yeah, cross is not in it now, so I have to take something. Yeah, cross is not in it, so I will do like this, that v1 is the self one dot cross and v2 is other. Still no luck. Okay, print is remaining, right? And print has three outputs. Okay, good. So you can see that cross is working. Okay, it is not this. This is not the limitation. We can have this dot. Okay, dot s comma zero. Okay, just 1 minute, it would be done. So for
so in the print will cross of v1 comma v2 will work
in the print,
right? Print cross v1 comma v2.
Just a second, I'll check. No, it won't, because it is self and other, right? And it is not double underscore right now. We are not having an operator in between.
Okay.
So there is a like ambiguity that which one is the self one, because sometimes we have different definitions, right?
Yes.
So sir. Here it is better to write v1 dot cross.
Okay.
Okay. I was doing this. So how will be the dot? It would be the multiplication itself, right? But right now, multiplication won't be used. I am not using vec3d. Okay, like vec3d pehle bhi use nahi kiya tha, but double underscore. So here asterisk would be used. But now I am just using dot. So if I just copy and paste. Vec3d has no attribute dot. Okay, I haven't ran it yet. Okay, right. Now, if you want to do something else like scalar triple product, STP, then also you can do. And this time you have already dot and cross product. So what you will do, this is nothing but scalar triple product. This is the last thing, scalar triple product. So what do we do here? Scalar triple product. So we have S, we have O. Let us take something as R. Okay. Now what we will do? We will make B we will take B is equal to S O R. So we can take S dot O cross R. Okay. So we will take O cross R. O dot cross R. And then we can return directly the dot product of S and B. Return S dot B. So if you want to say what is the scalar triple product of V1 comma V2 comma V2, it is not working, right? It should be something itself, so it would be V1 dot. Yeah. Why we get zero?
Mathematical answer. V2 and V2 are parallel.
Yep. So I'll take something V3 to check if it is working for otherwise. Okay. You may check that this all works correctly. Okay. So this is the end. Any questions? Okay. Ashish, what you said, okay. So double underscore using in this won't work, and I'm pretty sure it won't work. If you want, I can just try it for you, show what error it shows, and if it works, it's miracle, because I haven't. Wow, good. So you can do this, but then it is like, why would we use double underscore, right? Because this is taken as like, it was obvious that whatever we define can be used, but using this double underscore enables us to use the plus sign. Okay. So this would work. I'll see if there are any doubts in the chat.
Okay. Any questions from participants?
No, ma'am. No questions.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your informative session and fruitful session. Thank you once again.
Thank you, ma'am.